Cruise ships visiting Geiranger stop first at Helsult. This is where tenders take some passengers ashore so they can go on excursions, which will eventually bring them to Geiranger by road. Helsult is also the starting point for the Geiranger car ferry, which docks alongside the waterfall. The ships then sail on to the mouth of the Geiranger fjord. A sharp right turn leads into this 15-kilometre long fjord. The 2,000-foot tall cliffs rise above the deep, narrow canyon dotted with waterfalls, the best known of which is the Seven Sisters. Across the fjord is the suitor, who is said to be trying to woo the sisters on the opposite side. Just before Geiranger is the Eagle Road, with its 11 hairpins rising to 2,000 feet. It was built in 1955 to give year-round access to Geiranger Village. The tenders were launched at the foot of the Eagle Road to take us into the village. With two cruise ships in and over 5,000 passengers, you would think this village of 250 inhabitants would be swamped. But once they've taken selfies with the troll at the new terminal, they all seem to disappear. This was our fourth visit to Geiranger, but we never tire of its beauty. In all our previous visits, we've somehow never been on the waterfall walk, so we decided to do it this time. Formed from the melting snows at the top of the 5,000-foot Mount Dalsnibber, the river crashes down the mountainside before rushing into the fjord. A walkway with 327 steps and viewing points runs close to the surging Storfossen. The project cost over £1 million and took 20 years to complete. At the top of the walk are old farms with grass-covered roofs, and from here there's a stunning view over the whole valley, which, unsurprisingly, is a UNESCO World Heritage Site. Walking back by road, we came to the tiny church. These little village churches are made of wood to a common design, and have very uncomfortable pews, reputedly to keep the congregation awake during long, boring sermons. By now another ship, the coastal steamer, had arrived, bringing even more visitors. It was time to get back on the tender to go back to our ship, and relieve the pressure a bit.